So, where do we start? Assalamu alaikum.
Alaikum assalam.
What is your most treasured memory?
Most treasured memory? There's a lot of them, so I guess that's a good thing. My most treasured memory so far would be the day that I met my girlfriend.
All the time with my son. Every time I'm with him and he's having a good time and he's laughing, those are treasured moments for me. That's my little man. I like him.
When I was younger, my mom and I used to like take a bath. We would turn our backs facing and like write letters into the soap, and the other person would guess what it was.
It was that moment, I guess, when I finally got the dress on, I had the wig on. I had no clue what I was doing with the makeup. But it was the first time I finally felt like my gender identity and gender expression had aligned with each other. I was being myself.
I mean, to be quite honest, it may sound a little cliche, but I don't really have a problem with my upbringing. It, you know, shaped me and molded me into the woman that I am today. I feel like I'm a strong, independent woman.
I used to fight a lot, man. You know, I used to just fight. I had temper problems, man. Still do, but they calm down a lot. But I used to fight a lot.
Oh, I know how I'll die. I'm gonna die in a fire in the Bronx at age 88. That's what I, so I don't know. That's what the gypsy told me. Must be true.
So when I was 13 years old, I came home from soccer practice one day and my mom was like lying on the ground. She was, you know, like dying.
Oh my God.
Discovering her was like the most insanely traumatic event of my life.
I'm so sorry.
I was living with my boyfriend and he couldn't handle me having breast cancer. So after I had a mastectomy, we broke up.
You gotta feel like the world's coming down.
Yeah.
Around you, yeah.
The day that I left home at 16 is when I told my mom that, you know, I had gone through like a sexual abuse. She smacked me across the face and asked me if I was some sort of faggot. And I didn't even have the courage in that moment to tell her that the reason I was leaving is because, yes, I am gay. It wasn't cool. It's fine. I'm good now.
Yeah, you look great.
I'm single and dating and online, trying to see what it's like to date as a breast cancer survivor in her 40s.
Yeah, it seems like you're on the right path.
I hope so.
You know.
For what in your life do you feel most grateful?
Having the capacity to love after all of the trauma and craziness that I've been through in my life. I'm really honestly proud of that.
That's good.
You know, I just have the term carpe diem kind of in my mind. There you go. Nice. I don't have any tattoos, but I was thinking if I get one, it'll say carpe diem.
You should. It's a good one.
I think it's over. What did you think?
I feel like some weight has been lifted off my chest, so.
It's like therapeutic.
Yeah, it was nice talking to you.
It was nice talking with you, too.
Might as well bring it in. Come on, bring it in.